Well, good morning, Mrs. Winslow, and happy Monday.
Good morning. Happy Monday, Mr. Fairchild.
It's good to see you here, and I hope everything's been going well. Can you just tell me how you have been dealing with this quarantine in your household?
Well, not gonna lie, the first few weeks were tough. And I would say overall very challenging. As everybody knows, this is not your normal way to live and teach. So just trying to find that balance for me personally as a mom, and that balance finding it between being a mom and being a teacher and trying to teach out of my house and also be there for my two girls. So it's going okay. I think things are going better. It's just we're all adjusting and taking it day by day.
You know, I think having a birthday this time of year has got to be challenging for moms and dads trying to celebrate with being in this situation, do you think?
Yeah, I think so. I do. I know I've had several kiddos whose birthdays have been in April, and it's just different because in the classroom we have lots of different ways we celebrate them, and so just trying to find different ways of celebrating them, and along with the teaching, you know, still teaching, you know, using the same content, but just trying to find different ways to deliver that to them, and being creative along the way and just trying to do the best we can to meet everybody's needs.
Yeah. Well, speaking of birthdays, we have some birthdays this week, and I think you have the list in front of you, don't you?
Yes, I do.
All
you
right.
Ready?
Yes.
We have Kanae in Mrs. Keyswater's life skills class. We have Braden Mercer in 5Y. We have Eli Berkschneider in 4D. Maylee Marquette, she is in Mrs. Bettenhausen's class. And Maddie Rosemer, who is in my class this week. She's in my class this whole year, but she also has a birthday this week. So happy birthday to all of you, and I hope you all have a great day of celebrating just for you.
Yeah, happy birthday, Bobcats. Hopefully, find a great way to celebrate, I guess. So, what are you missing, Mrs. Winslow? What are you missing the most right now that you would have normally done prior to all of this shelter in place?
At school or at home?
At home. Normal life.
At home, normal life. I am a homebody, so I don't miss having to run around and try to, you know, get girls going every which way, or even like going to the grocery store. I hate grocery shopping. So I don't miss that, but I think just maybe the idea of just not being able to do the things we want to do, like go to the movies or go to a restaurant to eat, probably those types of things. But I actually, especially for the first few weeks, I love staying home. I think it's starting now, you know, as they've extended the deadline or the, you know, the date, it's starting to get a little bit more like, But the thank goodness for sunny days and being able to get outside and enjoy the weather. But I have to say, I am a homebody. I love to be able to be home and just, you know, sitting and enjoying time with my girls or reading a book, watching movies. So we've been able to do lots of that we don't typically do.
So what's one thing you are really looking forward to once the shelter in place is lifted?
I would say just, I'm a very huggy person, so just being able to see my friends and just give everybody a hug, I guess. I just, you know, that part of me is just missing. My girls are probably sick of me. But no, I love people and just being able to be around and not worrying about that 6 feet distance.
Yeah, that's great. I get that. Since you're on here, do you have anything you want to say to like all the kids at Banner, you know, the kindergarten all the way through fifth grade? Is there anything you want to?
Goodness, I miss seeing everybody. Like, I think that's probably one of the hardest things as far as a teacher, just not seeing everybody every day, you know, the students. Even though I teach second grade, you know, I get excited seeing kindergartners, first graders, and, you know, on up through the whole building. And I think we are such a close, tight-knit building that it's hard not to see those faces and get our morning greetings. You know, I miss the greetings in the morning, having hall duty and saying good morning to the kids and getting those, you know, high fives or the hugs. And so all of you Banner students. I miss you and I miss seeing those friendly faces. So, and just knowing what's going on with them. Yeah. So, I do.
So tell me, you've had to adjust your, I know being at Banner, you had a morning meeting every morning and you circled up and did a lot of cool things. How is that going right now?
It's a work in progress, but I have to say that I am so proud of my kids. They have really, you know, and I'm going to detour for just a second. We've worked all year on having a growth mindset, you know, as a learner and how important it is to be persistent and flexible. And they really have come through like shining stars. So even though we're not in the classroom and sitting on our carpet, those morning meetings we're able to do through Google Meet, and they have come up with some really great ideas, and they've helped me, I think, become even a better teacher. And we've all been learning together. So our morning meetings, we still meet every morning at 9:30. And Mondays and Fridays look a little bit different because we don't do the instruction. But it's the, you know, we do. We still have our meetings. We still start. We've been consistent with Mondays. We talk about what we did over the weekend. Tuesdays, we talk about, we do a take it or leave it. Wednesdays, we always do a would you rather. So it just kind of goes through. And they've been coming up with some fun activities on Fridays. Friday, we had a scavenger hunt. That was super fun. And I give the kudos to the kids because they have been super excited. And it's just a new way of doing things, but they have really truly shown me that it's, they have those growth mindsets.
Awesome. Hey, you said Wednesday is would you rather. I know it's not Wednesday, yes. But do you have a would you rather and or a joke? Define, or what have you got?
It was a would you rather never brush your teeth again or never be able to comb your hair again.
Wow.
I thought that was a hard one.
You know what? I think I gotta have clean teeth. So I think I would go with the, I would never comb my hair again, but I don't like that either. But I just don't think I would want a gross mouth. How about you?
It was definitely the, I would never want to comb my hair again. Because I'm very, I like my teeth to be clean and probably almost to the point of being obsessive about it. But although with long hair too, I'm like, oh my gosh, that could be kind of scary. But I would say definitely never comb my hair again.
Okay, I think that was an easy one for me too. But boy, yeah. Neither one sound very good.
But the
good.
Kids had some, they had some good good reasonings too behind their answers. So yeah, they did a good job.
Oh, good. All right, well, this one was submitted by the Wagner family. Okay. And would you rather be stuck in an elevator for 4 hours or stuck on a ski lift really high up for 4 hours?
That one to me is easy. Do you want to hear mine?
Yes, absolutely.
I would say a ski lift because I would not want to be confined in an elevator. In fact, when I get on an elevator, sometimes I'm like, oh, let's just get to our floor. So I'm not a big heights person either, but as long as we're standing still, I would be okay.
Okay, and you have a joke of the week. Did Lauren help you with this?
She did. Are you ready for this? I'll see if I can say it with enough emphasis here.
Okay.
What do you call a fake noodle?
No, there was such a thing.
I know. A fake noodle.
I don't know. What do you call a fake noodle?
You ready for this? Drum roll. An impasta.
Impasta, imposter, impasta. Play on words there. Lauren, what an awesome job. I love that one. Thank
good job
you.
On that one.
That's awesome. Hey, as we are getting ready to kind of conclude announcements here, I hear that your class is famous for doing some things on Friday. What are they doing on Fridays?
We have danced our way into the weekend, and so we play music and we dance our way into the weekend. So we play some music and we just have fun as we used to leave Banner, and we've continued to do that on our Fridays at the end of our Google meetings. We just kind of have a dance party.
Well, I think you shared some clips with me. Let's check out this dance party. Let's dance into the week. How does that sound? Right. Can we dance
that
into the week?
Awesome. Yeah.
Okay, let's check out Mrs. Winslow's class. Here, Mrs. Winslow, before we conclude the announcements.
I do. I have a few of them. Are you ready?
All right, Banner.
You belong here.
This is gonna be the best day of my life.